is methanol free power? Well, we'll find out today, because the test mule is back on the dyno. And I'm going to run through how, why, and what the advantages are of methanol tuning. As you can see, I've cleaned the car as well. So grab yourself a cuppa, bag of popcorn, whatever your favourite snacks are, and prepare for what might be a long video. Apologies in advance if it is. Make sure you stick around to the end, because I do have a discount code from Jennychem for the methanol if you want to take advantage of that. So you've had your car mapped, it's made what it's made, whatever that is, and you want a little bit more power, but without having to change the turbo or add other hardware in there. So this video might be for you. As always, I will be testing it with the standard map, just to give us a good baseline figure, so we can see whether there's any improvement with methanol. The car's strapped down, we are ready to rock and roll. So there we are, that's the baseline figure for today, 324 horsepower. Lost a couple of horsepower right at the top, and different fuel quality, different day, atmospheric conditions, but that's the baseline. So that's what we're gonna try and improve on with the methanol. There's three ways you can run methanol. You can run a water methanol injection kit, which works pretty well. You can run a flex fuel sensor, and an aftermarket ECU like a Cyvex, which handles it beautifully. But because on this car I am running the standard ECU, I'm just gonna splash it in the tank. So I arrived here with just over half a tank of fuel. So the fuel tank on the Forester STI is 60 liters. So I'm gonna run with a 25% mix of methanol, just because the maths are easier, and because I've got 5 litre containers, and 25% of 60 litres is 15 litres. So that's exactly 3 containers, so I know I can get the mix absolutely spot on. One thing I should say about this stuff, it is extremely toxic. 50 millilitres will cause blindness. 80 millilitres will kill you. So, take extreme care, don't store it anywhere near children. As you can see, the caps are just normal caps, they're not childproof. So be careful. So I've made some changes to the map, just some guesstimate changes at the moment for the ignition map. Added a bit more timing for the methanol, changed the fuel targets, and rescaled the injectors to allow it to add more fuel all over the map. So what are the benefits of running methanol? Firstly, it runs cooler, so you don't need as much fuel on boost to keep the piston tops cool. So you can run it leaner, make a bit more power from there. If your turbo also is at its maximum, by adding more oxygen, literally by pouring it in the tank, you will get a bigger bang, more power. The benefits, as far as gains are concerned, generally for this 25% mix that I'm running, generally around 10% extra power. You'll see in a while what difference it actually made to my figures. The downsides though, it's extremely toxic. It also has a very short life when it's opened, so that's why I've used three complete 5-litre containers, put 15 litres of fuel in. The big drums, the 205 litre or 210 litre drums, I think it is, they, you know, are much better value for money, but as far as storage, it's a nightmare and the methanol goes off. So I wouldn't recommend that. As you saw, I did a very quick overview of the changes that I made to the map in order to run it. I've done this many, many times. There will be a very, very detailed sort of walkthrough step by step, which will be part of the Mapping Academy videos that I'll be putting together slightly later in the year, which I'm really excited about. So stick around for information about that in future videos. Before I come to the results, I just have to say that results vary car by car. No two Subarus are the same. As if you've been around the scene for a while, you'll realize I could have 20 Subarus all with the same spec and they'll all make different power. So back to the original question, is methanol free power? Well, V-Power is currently £1.70 a litre, ouch. And the methanol containers that I got from Jennychem work out in the 5-litre version just over £2 a litre. Obviously the larger drums work out, I think it's about £1.42 a litre, so it can save you a little bit of money if you're buying the bigger drums, if you can use it quick enough before it goes off. But you also have to run about 10% more fuel, maybe a little bit more than that even. So the advantages aren't quite as great. But if your turbo has run out, you know, you're at the maximum what your turbo can produce, then, you know, if you're adding extra oxygen in liquid form, you're going to make more power and you're still going to keep the drivability of the smaller turbo that's on there rather than having to upgrade to a bigger turbo. So the moment of truth, what did it do? This is the before and after for today. So baseline figure for today, 324. We got with methanol 345.3. So as you can see, there's about a 20 horsepower gain all the way up through the power curve, which equates to about 35 pounds a foot of torque all the way through. So that will feel a lot perkier on the road. So is it worth it? You tell me. Write your comment below. Also, if you have any more questions, big questions, mapping questions, setup questions, whatever, also put them in the comments below. And obviously, don't forget to like this video if you like it, if you've made it this far. And of course, please consider subscribing. All that remains to be said now is see you next time. Yeah, no, I'm strut like I'm touchdown. I can do my dance like a touchdown.